I found these RF remote light switches in local store and decided to check if these could be connected to Home Assistant. The switches and relays were sold separately, so user can buy as many sockets and switches as needed and then pair those the way they want. I only bought this one switch, hoping I could make use of it without the same brand relays. I have made simple receiver on the PCB that I got from the sponsor of this video, PCBWay.com. Like name implies, they manufacture PCBs based on your designs, from simple two-layer PCBs to advanced multi-layer PCBs and assembled boards. They also offer services for other parts of our projects like 3D printing and CNC milling and much more. You can go to their website to see the current pricing and what services they offer. For up-to-date information, go check out PCBWay.com. Smart home systems like Home Assistant allow us to use fancy voice commands, sensor-based automations, and other futuristic ways to handle tasks in our everyday lives. No matter how many high-tech ways there are to control our devices, it's nice to have regular light switch-style switches as well. That's what most people are used to using, so non-tech savvy visitors won't panic if they need to switch lights on or off. That's why I think these would be a perfect candidate for easily deployed smart switches. These don't need any permanent wiring, or actually any wiring at all. This base can be screwed to the wall, in this case 23A 12V battery powers the switch, and these frame parts can be attached just by pressing them in. Unfortunately, I only have this one empty battery, so I'll use an external power supply and I will buy some more batteries if I get this to work as I wanted. Here is the receiver, which receives the signal from the RF switch and connects to Home Assistant. I know a couple people who want to build this kind of circuit, but don't want to use SMD or fine pitch components, so I decided to use Wemos D1 mini board and one of these RF receivers. This is the cheapest RF receiver there is, with the same frequency as the switch. That is the most important thing. Where I live, the generic RF receivers or devices use 433 MHz, so I need to use that same frequency receiver. These are so simple to use. There are three pins, data, VCC and ground. VCC and ground go to VCC and ground of the Wemos D1 mini. Data goes to any free GPIO pin. I decided to use pin D1. That's all that is needed in the hardware side. Like for so many different modules and components, there's an ESPHome component for popular RF and IR receivers. Once the signal is demodulated by the module, IR remotes and RF remotes signal become similar looking serial signals. That's why the same ESPHome component supports both types. I'll start with fresh ESPHome configuration with all the usual parts like board, API, OTA and Wi-Fi settings. What I will add first is remote underscore receiver component. For now I'll just define pin as D1 and dump as RC underscore switch. Dump configuration selects which received remote codes will be printed to the log. Usual protocol for remote controlled outlets and such is this RC switch. By specifying the correct one, we avoid getting metric shitton of unnecessary data in the log. While this doesn't do anything yet, nothing can be controlled with this code, it's necessary to upload this point and check the output log. After each button press, binary code specific to that button on that remote is printed to the log. Codes look quite similar, but one or two bits are actually different on each button. I'll save these values as they are needed very soon. There are many ways to transfer information from ESPHome to Home Assistant. I'm using binary sensor with platform called template, which means it can be set to on or off from the code. Descriptive name will be shown in the Home Assistant and an ID that is used in the code to control the state. Inside the remote receiver component, I have an on RC switch automation. That is automation that is triggered when signal with RC switch protocol is received. I have two if clauses checking if received code matches the one sent when off button is pressed or the one from on button. If so, previously mentioned binary sensor will be set to off or on accordingly. Once this is uploaded to Wemos D1 mini, I can go to Home Assistant, check the connected devices and inside this device I can see light switch binary sensor. That will switch on and off when button on the remote switch is pressed. State of that binary sensor can then be linked in the Home Assistant to control anything I want. It seems like these work fine. It's a nice off-the-shelf switch, and adding more of these switches should be quite simple. I just hope all the switches really have a unique ID like manufacturer promises. See you in next video. Thanks. Bye.